Hi, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Now, I've taken a kind of long break from YouTube, so please forgive me if my voice is kind of shaky or I trip over my tongue every once in a while. So basically, today I will be developing a character starting from some preliminary sketches to their clothes, their backstory, some concept art. Now, keep in mind, I am still somewhat of an amateur. My skills aren't quite where I want them to be, so please don't mind the fact that some of the art may be rough. If there's something that's really bothering you, please feel free to comment down below, give me some feedback on how I did and how I can improve. But let's get started. So the idea for this character popped up kind of out of random. I had a villager with a bowl cut with white hair, and it had they had some dangly bits that were like flowers and they were glowy, and I'm like, that looks like a straight alien. How about we make a character from that? So I drew like a little sketch in my sketchbook, and I thought, okay, so where do I want to go from this? Because obviously there is something here, but I don't know exactly where I'm supposed to be going. And even now, I don't know where I want to go. I have this character, I have some other characters, and that's pretty much it. I don't know where I'm going, I don't know where I'm gonna end up, but I think it's gonna be a good place if I put my mind to it. The concept for his characters, of course, they're sort of an alien, but they're also semi-cyborg. That plate on one side of their face is a metal plate. I don't know what happened to the other side of their face. Don't ask me what happened. I haven't figured it out yet. As you can see, they've got some volatile aquamarine hair. Yeah, in this sketch, I wanted to make their eye gold, but for some reason I didn't like that. I'll change their eye color in just a bit. Just see. I kind of love to change my mind when it comes to this sort of stuff. But if anybody liked the gold out there, don't worry, I'll stick to the gold eventually. In these sort of sketches, I just wanted to get the hang of how they would position themselves, how they would pose. Those two little sketches that I didn't outline were just two other ways that their face could look like that I didn't like. I don't know. I decided to go for like just the simple look of just face and antenna and faceplate, and that's it. I don't know what the emotional range for this character is, because I think at first all I wanted for them to be is just a blank slate, and then suddenly I just draw them with all of these facial expressions, so now I don't know what I'm doing. Also, I forgot to say this in the beginning, but like, I don't know how to record. It kind of looks kind of blinky, especially when I flip the canvas, so sorry about that. But anyway, back to this character. Dumb me was trying to figure out how to draw an elbow. Did I say their name? No, I didn't. Their name is kind of weird. Originally, their name was supposed to be Yui, like U-I, just two letters. And that was just an acronym for Undertale inspired, because that's literally all I have with this whole project. I want it to be sort of like Undertale. But then, like recently, I had a textbook that's like medical, and it said, hey, these are the names of different pharmaceutics, and if they end in this, they do this. I saw the one for that's supposed to be like antiviral, and I saw that it was just Ver, and I'm like, Ver's a cool name. Let's name this character Ver. And then I had a big brain moment, and I'm like, how about let's combine Ver and Yui? So this character's name is now Verwi. Ver, I swear, this is still pending. If you feel like you have something better, feel free to comment down below. I am open to some suggestions. And yeah, I used a lot of transform tools because my anatomy is rough. My anatomy is so rough. Sometimes I like outline a whole thing. See, like just right there, I realized that they're supposed to be like laying on a horizontal, like straight horizontal plane, and then they were slanted. So I just corrected the whole thing. My favorite part is basically like drawing the outlines of the faces, because their hair is very extremely angular. Oh yeah, and this face in particular, why there's a little indentation on that side of the face where the plate is supposed to be is because I wanted to see what it would look like if you could just tear the plate off, and then I'm just like, nah. Like, I color it in and everything, but I never dwell on that. I just forget about it in like a second. Also, whenever I was putting them at this angle, see that little circular thing that's where their ear is supposed to be? Yeah, I thought it was supposed- I thought I wanted them to have sort of like earphones, I guess. And so, I imagine this character can feel pain, you know, because I sort of drew them crying and everything. This character is gonna fall down from the moon or wherever the fuck they came from. They're gonna fall down and they're gonna try to survive in this new weird world that they landed in. Oh, here's a tidbit about the coat. The character lands in some sort of cloth, but the scarf and the boots, I figure that they just get that later because I feel like that would be a good plot point. And this is where I finally put in the full image of Virui. By this point, I haven't drawn their feet too much. Like in the last page, yeah, you see a couple of poses with their boots and stuff. But like in the first page, I basically don't show their feet. And here I work out the body proportions and everything. I am horrible at body proportions, by the way. Whenever I try to draw characters side by side, they just never look right. I think this is a prime example of it, especially because I didn't know what kind of physique I wanted them to have. I wanted them to look kind of small in comparison to the other characters, but also them to wanted to look kind of, I guess, praying mantis like. So here it does look like they're kind of lanky, but later on I guess I'm gonna draw them side by side next to some other characters and they're just gonna be short. Yeah, also I have a horrible sense of like leveling. That's why I'm flipping my canvas all the that's why I'm flipping my canvas all the time, because I don't know what's slanted and what's not. For instance, I can see it right away because I've been through this hellhole so many times, but one boot is larger than the other. That is concerning. Oh, that's the first thing you saw me. The fact that the feet are off center. Cool. Good to know. How about the fact that one boot is like so much smaller? Also, when it comes to boots, I have a hard time connecting them to the feet because sometimes, see, you see like the way I connect them to like the legs and you just realize that the feet are at a horribly malformed angle. Yeah, so I just called it quits and duplicated the leg and moved on with my day. Thank you very much. But here I have some more, I have another hard time with the boots. Then I just like shift them around because they're not evenly dispersed and I just have to be a perfectionist about it, even though I really need to curb my perfectionism sometimes. And now I'm just determining that everything is at a wrong angle. My god, that everything's so slanted. Also, I just forgot to say, my layer names can sometimes be weird. Like, I make huge logical jumps to just make weird layer names because I want to. See, this is what I was talking about. And this sort of relates to the Animal Crossing character I was talking about, because they had these little glowy thingamajigs on their head that you'd win probably from like a bug catching contest. I had like a bunch of those, and basically the effect they'd make is they'd make the top of your head look either greenish or bluish or aquamarine-ish, and then since my character's hair was white, the ends of the hair would look white. It's sort of that, but their natural Virui's natural hair color is aquamarine. The antenna is emit light, but it's very weak. Yeah, they look extremely lanky and they're not supposed to. I think it's rather the fur coat. I call it a fur coat, but I don't know what it's made of. Nothing in this video is written in stone, by the way. Like, I might not like one of the colors one day and just change it. One day this character might not even be wearing leggings or gloves. Maybe one day I'll change their eye color from gold to silver, you know? And none of this is set in stone. All of it is subject to change. Also, I'm just fixing the shoes platforms because they look very deflated right now. Oh wow, you didn't fix that last one. Way to go, me. And this is probably my favorite one out of all of them. This is just like facial expressions just all over the place. And this is where I thought, okay, this character has more emotional range than I initially would think them to be. Did I mention how much I like drawing their hair? It's just very angular. I can just draw a line in which direction and it's still gonna look good. And so yes, this first facial expression is just kind of a neutral one, kind of like, I'm judging you silently, but I won't tell you. And this is totally that sort of character where their antennas determines their emotions. So see, whenever they're just a little bit happy, like in this emotion right here, their antennas, instead of just dangling uselessly, they just curve a little bit in because, you know, they're just pleased to be here. And apparently they have a vascular system because they can blush. And they have meat apparently underneath, according to that one thing that I drew back then. I don't really know the lore. I know they're an alien and I know they're semi-cyborg. That's all I know. And whenever they're a bit more, you know, hurt, maybe they're like in pain or emotionally hurt, their antenna basically goes floppy. Who has time focusing on antennas when you're upset? But like whenever they're upset, I guess the internal temperature of their brain just melts their eyeball, since their eyeball is composed of like, I concluded that it was composed of gold or something. So their eyeball just melts, which is them crying or like tearing up, you know? They can also get angry, which Yeah, okay. I can't imagine a scenario where they can get angry. Yeah, but when they get angry, their antenna go totally rigid and they just stick out to the sides and angry stuff. Oh yeah, and apparently Virui can also sleep. I also can't imagine a situation where they need to sleep, especially because like this whole idea is supposed to be like an RPG thing, and I'm not planning to put any ins or anything like that, so they're either gonna be sleep deprived or they're gonna be the type of cyborg that doesn't need sleep. You know, now that I'm looking at it, I think that kind of aquamarine is a bit too greenish for my liking. I'd like it to be more vibrant, more blue. And now, supposedly the biggest piece of them all, and probably the messiest that one I've ever done. Actually, that's a lie. The rough sketches were the roughest one I've ever done. But this is supposed to be like the grand image that I've done after my self-reflection after developing this character. But like, who am I kidding? It's so rough. The idea for this whole image, I wanted to go lineless, which probably was the biggest mistake of them all. I don't know whether that was a mistake or whether it was a good thing, because I do like the way it looks lineless, see, like that, but then it leaves a lot of gaps. But the idea for this whole thing was it was just gonna be Virui sleeping in a forest full of shrooms. Yes, indeed. I have had like a fascination with shrooms because some shrooms are fucking butt ugly, but then there are other ones who are just like these beautiful things, and I'm like, how are you people related? Yeah, I don't want to insult them, but some of you look like garbage. I saw shrooms on the ground the other day. They were really soft and they looked edible. I think this character, if this character was any living organism other than themselves, they would be a mushroom. Mushrooms, some of them can be pretty, but most of all, they're really soft. Mushrooms are unbelievably soft. So this image is full of mushrooms. You can't really see them too well yet because I've been focusing on Virui. Also, a random triangle appeared because I'm an idiot and I guess I wasn't paying attention. I don't know how that triangle appeared, to be honest. I'll notice it eventually, don't worry. Let's see, at some point the recording is gonna cut out because by a certain point, whenever I was drawing this, I realized, oh my god, there are too many mushrooms. This is gonna take me forever. So yeah, I'm gonna just, I guess, color in a couple of mushrooms and then it's just gonna be filled in at some point and I'm just gonna be as surprised as you are. Oh yeah, so this is where I jumped. Whew. See, so these are all, most of the mushrooms done, and this is basically me filling in the ground and the grow for the grass. The grass is pink, the ground is purple. I like psychedelic looking scenes. And then I basically go ham on the background because I didn't really know how to make the background look detailed but also not very detailed at the same time, because I wanted to create a feeling that there was something behind those mushrooms, like more mushrooms behind the mushrooms, because it is a mushroom forest. So I tried using different kind of texture brushes going along with different colors. This is supposed to be like leaves, even though this is a mushroom forest and there are literally no leaves to be seen. Those are like 10 brushes on top of each other. See, more. It just looks like fucking disco lights by this point. Oh yeah, and I was really confused when I saw this brush. I'm like, what the fuck is this brush trying to tell me? And then some polka dots, you know, some good old polka dots. Oh, and then I thought, oh, let's make a trail on the ground. And that took me quite a while to figure out how to do. I tried adding some pink in there. It failed horribly, so I'm just like, yeah, let's just do the blue. Actually, this last piece came out much better than I initially thought. Like, I did the rough line work, and I'm just like, okay, so this looks complicated, and this may turn out okay, but I'm probably gonna fuck it up sometime. So I may have fucked it up, but from far away, it looks kind of fine. But yeah, that's gonna be that for this video. Thank you so much for joining in. I still have some projects in the works relating to this character, as I already probably mentioned. I do have a couple of more characters that I would like to talk about and probably factor them in. I really want to build a story around Virui and this mushroom world, I guess. The mushroom world's gonna be just like one area, you know? Oh, if you made it this far, why? Like, I'm not questioning you, but I am questioning you. Why did you make it this far? Yeah, but if you made it this far, maybe subscribe and hit that notification bell if you want to see more. You can follow me on Instagram if you want. I'm probably going to put the link in the description. And on Instagram, I sometimes do like video related stuff, but usually it's just random stuff I draw and I fuck around. But yeah, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.